Overseer Terminal. Unfortunately, the floor is not going to, ooh, the cryolator. I've long dreamed of making cryogenic freezing available in a portable on-demand form, blah, blah, blah. Tinker with the prototype. It's nice. Sweet. Okay, we've already looked at the operation protocol. We've already looked at the, overseer instructions. Yep. And open. Oh, let's check out the log. So, preparations. The final staff orientation is complete. All but the few of the residents down the Sanctuary Hills have been enrolled, and several from Concord as well. Alright. So I guess the place where I lived was Sanctuary Hills, in that little idyllic neighborhood. Ah, fresh water. It happened. We were lucky that most of the staff were nearby when the early warning came through. We had less notice than expected, but only Nordhagen was missing when we sealed the entrance. I'll look for Nordhagen when I get back to the surface. Alright, system malfunction. Strange issue today with Pod C3. Subject appeared to have heart palpitations. Nothing life-threatening, but unusual. We realized almost too late that the pod was malfunctioning. The cryogenic ray almost started thawing her out. No! We're not sure, but I suspect a hiccup in Vault-Tec's remote override system may have sent an errant signal. God damn it, Vault-Tec, you screwed me! There's been no all clear yet, even though we've nearing the end of the 180 days. Yep, they only stocked up for freaking 6 months. And now look at them, they're running out of supplies! I can't open the vault. I can't expect our supplies to last forever. I just have to keep everything under control until the all clear! And then final message. Mutiny. Yep. Damn, he shortened their rations. Hunger makes people do crazy things. Let's get out of here. Alright, evacuation tunnel open. Anything else in this room? Huh? Lockpicks? Bobby pins? Bobby pins are lockpicks, so freaking pick that shit up. Alright, I got a gun now, and I can switch with D-pad. So I got a security baton. Oh, shit, I gotta press X. There we go. Security baton for melee! Which, by the way, melee is the better option for this little first area, because rad roaches can fly around and shit, and I don't have VATS yet, so just bash them! Bash them good! Yeah! Where'd you go? Where'd you get got? Die! Ah, no! Yeah, you see, you can't really aim at this. They move too fast. They're too swift. Alright. Pick up all that delicious roach meat. Yeah. Okay. Let's get out of here. Nowhere to go. I got my gun. I got my melee. I'm ready for the wastelands, baby. Oh no, roach! Boom! Dead. Oh, shit! Freak of nature! Die! To perform an attack while wielding a gun, press R1. Yeah, I know. It's the same attack button as always. Oh, look, the cryopods. We're back at the entrance. We did not walk very far to get to the vault. That's water. I don't know if I can drink this or not. It might not be safe. Alright, so how do we open up the vault? What do we got here? It looks like a retina scanner. Nope. Shit. Pip-Boy interface? Hey, look, a Pip-Boy! Have a nice day. Take it off of his skeletal hand! Give me that. Yeah! Oh! Nice! Pip-Boy! 4,000, I think. Oh, I want one. Although, I don't want one that looks like that, because it looks like a piece of shit. I can just duct tape my phone to my wrist and have a Pip-Boy. Alright, Pip-Boy version 7.1.8.0. I think that's what it was. Yeah! Thumbs up, Vault Boy! Change tabs! Alright. Dun 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 dun! Dun 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 dun! Oh shit, yeah, that's right, the radio. I don't think we'll be able to listen to radio in this game. YouTube won't let me. It might flag the videos or something. I guess we could listen to classical radio. The copyright on that has surely hit free use or fair use status by now. Also, you can't repair shit in your inventory anymore. That was like one of the cooler things about Fallout 3. You could just like repair on the go. I have like 8 hunting rifles. Now I've got 1 hunting rifle and it's invincible. But now I can't do that anymore. I gotta like find a bench and break down these older guns into like just parts and then use those parts to upgrade the newer gun. I got the Red Menace, I got bobby pins, I got nothing. I got nothing, that's what I got. Alright, so I've got a Pip-Boy, and I can use VATS now. Can't do it right now, because there's no living thing near me. Ah, let's get out of the vault. Oh look, it's got a little computer node. How cool is that? Remote access. It's like the freaking early version of a USB.
Vault door cycling sequence.
Ready for hell! Please. I'm ready to unleash hell on the wastelands. Ha ha! Yeah! Ooh, physics! Gah! Physics on the gate. Come on. Oh, I was using the bash. Just use regular melee. Look at those sparks flying. Dude, that is like a crazy powerful attack. If I can cause sparks to fly with my bashes, hell yeah. Alright, the vault. The vault door is open. Ah, oh, it's so bright. Let me out! Yeah. Dun, 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 dun. Here's what I want to do. I want to make a permanent, actual, for real save right here. Yeah, save. Look at all these save datas. Wow, freaking PlayStation 4 saves datas a lot! Damn! Alright, I guess I'll just make a new save data. Yes. There we go. I wish I could like label this something else, but whatever. There we go. So now if I wanna like, if I do the first recording session and then I'm like, let me go do character creation, I can come back to here and just do that. Because right now, it's our last chance to change shit, change name and special. Don't wanna change the special? No, I don't. I wanna keep it as is. Oop, shit. No. There we go. And change of face? I don't want to do it right now. I'll do it later. Yeah. What I'll probably do is like I said, I want to get to the point where I was. I want to make new progress. So I want to redo all the shit that I've already done. So I got to level 5 and I did like 2 story quests. So let's do that. And then once we're done with the actual recording session, I'll go back on my own time and fix my character a little bit or I don't know, change the attributes if I deem them unworthy. And then I'll just redo all the missions. It won't be too hard. Whoa, the sun! Here comes the sun! Doo-doo-doo! Oh, it's just as beautiful as I didn't remember it. Ah, it's blurry. I used to think that, in Fallout 3, I would always put on the sunglasses before I walked out the vault door. The tortoise shell glasses that you find. Because I thought maybe that would like protect your freaking eyes from the intense sunlight. What do we got? Bottle cap. That is money. For those of you who don't know, should I assume that people know Fallout when I play this game? Because I mean like I said, everybody's going crazy bananas over this. So I would guess that a lot of people have played it, or watched somebody else play it, which, by the way, I am not watching anybody play this. I want to experience this firsthand, baby! So, yeah! I'm trying to not crouch. There we go. So, whatever experiences I have, they're my experiences, and they're precious to me. You know? You guys are welcome to watch, whatever. It's not going to impede my fun having. A Nuka-Cola. And hey, they redesigned the bottle for wherever the hell we're at. How did they redesign the bottle? Did they freaking open up another plant? I don't know. The elevator button? Nope. Nope. Okay. So, sweet. Skeletons everywhere. Everybody's dead. Let's go. Let's go and not regret it. Where the hell are we? We can check the map. Oh, wait! We can activate the music, I guess. Because, yeah, Diamond City Radio. Unfortunately, we will not be able to listen to Diamond City Radio on this playthrough because I don't want to get all of my videos flagged for content ID matches. We can probably listen to classical radio because, like I said, free use is fair use. It has probably activated in all the freaking music that plays on classical radio. So yeah, enjoy the sultry tones of some of the classics. And by classics, I mean like fucking Renaissance era classics. Like Beethoven, Mozart, other stereotypical guys. Ugh. So yeah, actually, wow, this is kind of sad. Oh, look, it's the same people that were trying to get into the vault. They're dead. No! What has happened here? Also, Skyrim, you can gather flowers. For what? I don't know. Have I mentioned the fact that I have not played more than like an hour of Skyrim? Like, I did the freaking prologue and got to like city place, and then I was like, this doesn't appeal to me. Because it didn't! I'm not a fan of fantasy. I'm not a fan fantasy. I like sci-fi, which is why Fallout and Mass Effect and, you know, that sort of stuff. It's right up my alley. Sci-fi! Yeah! Alright. We could explore, as is the nature of a Fallout series, or we could go straight to the objective. Now, this is cool, my little compass down there. If it's exactly like it was in Fallout 3, it'll give me like little notifications when I'm just dicking around, going nowhere. So let's see, like, see, there's the vault. It's got the symbol of the cog, of the vault cog. And then, like, if I start, I think I saw there was like a log cabin over here that had something cool in it. And look at that, lo and behold, on the little compass down there, there's like a little symbol for a shack, or a house, I guess, some kind of shelter. And let's head over there right now, actually, because I remember there being great things to be had. Also, military vehicle, nice. Glowing fungus. Or growing fungus. What do we got? Stimpak, you've taken radiation damage, reducing your max health. Visit a doctor. Oh shit! Oh shit, I'm being radiated! No! Pay attention! Pay attention to your HUD. Clipboard. Wait a minute. Ammo box! Oh shit! Mosquitoes! Ah! Ah! Fucking... Fallout New Vegas had bloat flies! No! Oh god, that is creepy! You motherfucker! Oh god, Fallout 4 has giant mosquitoes. Run! Use a stim pack. Yeah. Okay. All better. Well, actually, no, not all Betty. All better. My maximum health has been lowered thanks to radiation. So now radiation is like a new thing. Or actually, it's not a new thing. It's been redesigned, I guess. And, here we go. Here's a shack. In Fallout 3, radiation would just give you, like, debuffs when you hit a certain threshold. If you hit 200, you lost, like, a perception and a strength. Ah, look! It's a bloatfly from, Fallout New Vegas. Oh, shit. That's another one. Let's practice our marksmanship. How you doing? No, not V.A.T.S. Oh, shit, there's another one! No, don't bash him with the gun! Shoot the gun! Shoot the gun! Bullets out of the gun! Yeah! Yeah, aiming is not how you're supposed to play Fallout, believe it or not. This is not a freaking first-person shooter by nature. So don't play it like one. You're supposed to use V.A.T.S. when you can. Alright, hot plate, hell yeah. Wasteland Survival Guide. Sweet, I found my first book. Nice. Boom! Look at that. That is a crudely drawn comic book by a survivor. You've collected an issue of Wasteland Survival. Permanently take 5% less damage from melee attacks. Awesome! Done. I don't know if you have to have that in your inventory in order for it to always be working. Or if you can, like, store it in your, I don't know, safe house? Safe? Stockpile? Whatever you want to call it. Anyway, I don't know if it'll work if it's outside of your inventory. Like, if you just have possession of it. And hey, a chemistry station! Hell yeah, you know what? Let's see if we can do a little bit of tinkering right now. Because there's a lot of crafting to be done. I could make a bleed-out syringe. That is it. And that's not even like a thing I can use. It's ammo for a freaking gun I don't have. Alright. Oh, shit. Actually, cancel that, because I want to explain something about the crafting system. So, it's asking for... Well, actually, hold on. I guess it's actually asking for stuff over here. Yeah, purified water, rad away. Mines? It's... Okay, so here's a good example. The bottle, the cryo mine. It wants acid, adhesive, aluminium, and a nuclear material. Now, you'll notice that I have one acid. I don't remember picking up any fucking corrosive acid puddles on my trip through the vault, but Fallout 4's crafting system automatically it doesn't do it right away, but it automatically sort of like calculates what components you have based on what's in your inventory. So like, I picked up probably something that has circuitry in it, and it tells me that I've got 4 circuitry. I do not have 4 circuitry. I have 4 things in my inventory that could be broken down into circuitry. So if I decided to craft them, it would do the breaking down of those items. Speaking of items, do I got any food? Let's see. Aid. There we go. Bloatfly meat. It'll heal me, but it'll also irradiate me, which will lower my maximum health. Not what I want. Ooh, cram. Pre-war food. Always good. Gives you lots of healing. And, what about the flowers that I was picking up? Stem belt? Wait, what? Oh, it's a bean. It's another plant. And I got 7 stem packs. Might as well use one. There we go. So there we go. I ate some food. Stomach's full. We are not going to be playing this game in survival mode. Were I to reboot, not reboot, but play Fallout New Vegas for the channel, I would definitely play on survival mode because I love that shit. Ammo has... ammo can weigh you down in fucking survival mode. And you need to drink and eat regularly, otherwise you'll die. What was I talking about a while ago? It was the radiation. So yeah, in Fallout 3, when you hit like 200 radiation, you lose some strength. If you hit 400, you lose some damage resistance and action points. And in Fallout... And when you hit 1,000, you just straight up die. I guess in Fallout 4, they reworked it so that... Your radiation like lowers your maximum health, and then like that's it. You don't necessarily get reduced stats yet. Actually, I don't know. I've never gotten higher than like 25, or I've never really gotten let my radiation go up that high because I don't like the prospect of having reduced maximum health. That's not fun. All right, put up gun. I don't know if we can run faster with or without the gun, but I don't want to risk it. Let's do a story mode mission and try to make some freaking progress. Here we go, main town! Hooray! You can search and stuff. Hey, let's do a bit of cooking, actually. You can now use this workshop sanctuary. Ow! What the fuck? Oh, it's a bug! It's a rad roach! Bash it! Don't use ammo on it! What the fuck? There's more bugs! Fuck you! Ah. Any more roaches? See, my perception is shit, so I didn't even notice that bug until it was right up on me. Craft. What can we make? I can roast something. Yeah! Oh, I can grill up some rad roach meat! Do it! Rad roach grilling. That also earns me some experience. Anything else? Nope. Sweet. So the healing benefits of the 3 rad roach meats have been freaking combined into one delicious rad roach grill, which heals 30 HP and does not irradiate me because I cooked it properly. Yeah. Okay. What other aid do I have? I need to like reduce my radiation. Actually, do I have any rad away? I do, but I don't even have that many rads. How many rads do I have? Hold on. Looking, searching. Where does it let me know how many rads I have? It doesn't? Oh, there's like a little Giger counter over there where my my knuckle of my thumb is. And I can't really read it that well. I guess I'm at 200 rads. Right? And a rad away will get rid of 300, so I guess I don't want to use the rad away just yet. Okay. Come on. Modding and crafting stations are located and will automatically share your store with them if... But only if you've unlocked the workshop in their location. So I need to find the workshop. Also, Cobsworth is here. And he's probably got some shit to say. Hi there! Hello! Hey, Cobsworth, you look a little rusty. I'll fix you up.
As I live and breathe!
Actually, hold on. For this shit, let's turn off the radio.